Well, isn't that a surprise? Like the Japanese attack on David Harbour.
Hi, Kenji Mifune, Tokyo Daily. Why do you always look like you just woke up in a dumpster?
What do you want your alias to be?
What are you talking about? I'm not gonna...
Pick a name for yourself!
Willem Dafoe.
Ugh, not that one. I used to have a Willem Dafoe living under my bed.
Hey, you asleep yet?
No.
Just checking.
Peter, what the hell are you doing?
Lois, I am doing my duty as a patriotic American. I'm sacrificing a goat to Toby Keith.
Peter, Toby Keith doesn't want to be fed. Toby Keith wants to hunt.
Hey, listen, don't tell me what Toby Keith wants. I think I'm perfectly capable...
Look!
It's old sitcom stars. They're coming out of the cornfield. It's Jenna Elfman. Tony Danza. And,
Trailer Howard from Two Guys and a Girl.
Yeah, you're not a star. You shouldn't be in a cornfield.
But I was also in the later seasons of Monk.
I see. Now your list of credits includes Castle.
What, like you think you have a shot with her?
Are you kidding? We'll go together better than Hannity and Combs. My problem with liberals, Alan, is that liberals hate America.
Sean, I don't know if that's true.
You just contradicted me. You hate America.
If I could just get a word in.
You hate America. You like the terrorists.
Well, I guess you're right again.
And now back to Kids Say the Darndest Things.
It's okay, take your time. Then what happened?
He said he would kill me if I ever said anything.
Do you remember what he looked like?
Yeah. He had a scar on his arm, and he had a big, stupid doo-doo head.
A big, stupid doo-doo head!
Honestly, the things these children come up with.
Paul!
Oh, yeah. Who's the big man now, eh?
Madonna or Janet Jackson?
Where's Janet Jackson?
Velvet Rope.
Yeah, that one. Paul!
Peter, what the hell are you doing with that thing? Albert Einstein worked for the patent office.
And what is it you want to patent, Herr Smith?
I call it Smith's theory of relativity.
Hey, look at this.
What?
We now return to Alice and Janney in Hello, Sexy.
And to your left, you'll see a joke about Alice and Janney being very, very tall. She has an Oscar, and we have a great deal of respect for her.
Sorry, in this town you can only buy alcohol if you're dressed head to toe in jeans.
What? Who made that law?
Our mayor, Jay Leno.
Have you seen some of these laws they've got now about denim? You know, I say, if you don't like it, you may as well Levi's.
Who's voting for these mayors?
Rhode Island's a mess from top to bottom.
If you make Belichick smile, I'll let the Patriots win again.
Oh, okay, you're on.
I don't know, Peter, that's gonna be tough.
Don't worry, I got a lot of practice making people smile.
Okay, shh, here he comes.
Hiya, Mr. Belichick.
Who the hell are you? What do you want?
We are here to make you smile. And if there's one thing that always gets me to smile, it's a child's laughter. So, I found this kid in the parking lot, and I'm gonna make him laugh for you. Come on, laugh! Would you, Bubba? Would you?
Don't touch my son's face. Get over here, little man. This flight is cleared for liftoff. Vroom. Liftoff.
Wee.
Who's flying?
Wee.
You're flying.
Again.
Who's daddy's little jet?
I love you, daddy.
Guys, I guess we failed. Sorry for wasting your time, Coach. We gotta get to the hospital anyway. Our friend Joe here has to have his fluids changed every 72 hours or else he swells up and his eyes turn yellow.
What was that?
Oh my God, Joe, quick, tell him more about your sad life!
Every morning I wake up drenched in my own urine. My feet are just shoes sewn to the bottom of my pants. Last week, the handicap seat on the bus was taken, so they put me on the front like a bicycle. After I injured my legs, my doctor said I'd be walking again in 2 weeks.
Huh. That's hysterical.
Oh my God, yes!
All right! He smiled!
We did it!
I say, this is more uncomfortable than having James Brady at a cocktail party.
All right, so I got my handgun, and I'm just randomly firing it into a crowd of people, and then...
And then what?
Nothing.
No, I'm anxious to hear the conclusion of your story.
That's stupid. Stupid story.
Hi, Peter. I'm really looking forward to the movie tonight. Peter and I are going to see Zapped. I figured Scott Baio was androgynous enough that we could both fantasize about him and no one would be gay.
Oh, no way. Hey, Chris, look. Is that Richard Dreyfuss?
Oh, for crying out loud.
Hey, Dreyfuss, where are you going? Get back here. Dreyfuss, what are you doing here in Quahog?
My nephew's in the play. God, can't you go anywhere these days without these damn paparazzi?
Where are you going? Oh, are you going to the bathroom? You gonna have a close encounter of the turd kind? Hey, I think you're gonna need a bigger boat. These jokes are for you, Peter, when you watch this tape in the future.
We did it!
Wow, look at us! You know, we make a great team, guys. Like Huey Lewis and the Jews.
You don't need money!
Sorry, the band's breaking up.
You're being terrible parents. Even worse than John Edwards.
Kids, we need to talk. Your mama has cancer, and it's made me incredibly horny. Take care.
What's going on? Did I miss something?
Just some idiot streaking across the field.
Ha ha. You are all looking at my penis. You didn't plan on it, but it's happening.
Now, you'll be watching Stewie, and I don't want you just to prop him up next to the TV all day. Take him to the park. I want him to get some fresh air.
Fresh air is bad for a kid, Lois. Look at Michael J. Fox.
What?
I don't know.
I'm not gonna die, Brian. I'm like Jim Belushi. I am worried about my funny brother, though. Food fight! This is tragic, but will also open a door for me.
Peter, this is so much fun. I feel like I have a secret lover nobody else knows about. Just like Carly Simon.
Miss Simon, enough years have gone by since you wrote your classic hit, You're So Vain. Don't you think it's time to tell the world who that song was written about?
No, that will always be a secret between me and him.
You're so vain. You probably think this song is about you. You're so vain.
Will you relax? We got an ironclad alibi. We were all seeing the Beatles live at the Ed Sullivan Show. Sorry, I rode a bike here. But recent years have also seen many important historical events. 1985 brought us the gayest music video of all time. That happened, and we all let it happen.
This is the Seth Rogen gene. It will give you the appearance of being funny, even though you haven't actually done anything funny.
Hey, Doc, are we going to be much longer? I got to get some beers with the fellows before I go out on this date.
How charming and chubby. I'm rooting for you.
Remember that time I was Robin Williams jumping off point? Okay, religion.
Huh, religion. You kill me, I kill you, we both go to heaven. 72 virgins, huh? You might have to help me out with the last 10 or so,
because Mr. Happy gets tired.
Religion.
Politics.
Huh, politics. Well, we're gonna come down there and take all your oil, but this is our oil. Yee-haw! Well, here's my missile. Okay, take it. Politics.
You know what? I'm gonna take a 5-minute break.
Huh, 5-minute break? What are you, a construction worker? Hey, baby, I'm not gay.
Does this yellow hat make my ass look fat?
5-minute break.
Help! Somebody! These drunk redneck truckers are trying to have their way with me!
Not while my scrotum is pressed up against my stomach in these jeans, they won't. Roadhouse.
It turned out the joke already had quite a history. Bruce had heard it from Consuela. Consuela heard it from Mayor West. West heard it from Dr. Hartman. Hartman heard it from Angela. Angela from Opie. Opie from Herbert. Herbert heard it from Tom Tucker. Tucker heard it from Bender on Futurama, oddly enough, for some reason. Bender heard it from Al Harrington. Harrington from REO Speedwagon.
Heard it from a friend who... Heard it from a friend who... Heard it from another...
REO Speedwagon saved us several stops, as they too had backtracked the joke to some extent. But when their trail had led to a bartender in Virginia, they had given up, much the way the world had given up on them. In fact, just to kick him a couple extra bucks, here's 5 seconds of Time for Me to Fly.
No, don't! All the money goes to my bitch ex-wife!
Can you play our song?
Okay, lead singer from Asia.
Now, sure as the sun across the sky, this lie is over.
Well, take it easy. You're getting a bigger head than Chris Matthews.
The economy's in the news today, and Congress is considering a minimum wage increase. Live by satellite to talk about it, Senator Harry Reid in Washington. How about it, Senator Reid? Is this the right move during the worst recession since the 1930s?
Look, if we're going to get this economy back on track, we have to get more money in the pockets
but
of
Republicans are saying
Americans
this increase is going to, in fact, put more people out of work and make
Instead
it harder for American employers to compete in the global
the
marketplace.
Who caused this collapse.
Wouldn't it?
Chris,
Senator, let me finish. My forehead, my rules. Let's go to Los Angeles. Big actor played the father in that 70s show, Kurtwood Smith. How's it going, Kurtwood?
Good. Thanks for having me.
You tweet things that aren't worth tweeting.
Well, I'm sorry, but Kim Kardashian did get famous for making a sex tape.
We all know that. That's not yours.
Whoa, it's like I'm high-fiving with Anthony Edwards. And it's not like I'd be lying.
There we go. Hey, another round for me and my veteran buddies.
Dad, Family Guy used two of your songs.
Well, that's great, but I'm not your dad. I'm Kenny Loggins, and you're a groupie I brought here for sex.
Dad, Family Guy just...
See, now that's my daughter.
And now, the Game Show Network presents, are we talking about Jake Gyllenhaal or Jared Leto?
I am oily-haired with dinner plate eyes. I was in that one movie about the weirdo. I somehow look both deathly ill and ripped. I am a less successful version of Tobey Maguire. Anyone? No? You would totally believe any story about me being a dick.
I'm changing the channel. I like both of them.
Ah, yeah. Peanut butter cup, Dorito sausage car panini. And let's crack a Cadbury egg over the whole thing. Just gonna use my spare glove compartment underwear as a napkin. I can't believe Randy Quaid gets to eat like this every day.
Hey, Lois, look over there. It's Jessica Chastain.
Oh, Daddy, that's Bryce Dallas Howard. You're blind as a bat.
We now return to another Michael Jordan underwear commercial on a plane for some reason.
Does your underwear have tags?
What? Mr. Jordan, you're going to have to take your seat and stop asking people about their underwear.
Oh, boy, I remember my first job. I was in a folk music trio. Hey, how about here's to you, Mrs. Fleckenstein?
Yeah, you've been pitching that for an hour, but it's just not a very attractive name.
Oh, fine. I suppose we're also not going with parsley, sage, rosemary, and Lowry's seasoning salt. That's it, I'm going to Nam. Hey, if there's one thing I'm good at doing, it's cheering people up. Mr. and Mrs. Ramsey, John Bonet's untimely death is a tragedy, and I will not rest until I find her killer. Or killers.
Oh, really? Don't bother. Nothing's going to bring our baby back.
No, I insist. I will make it my life's work to find
We're
out...
Fine, just drop it.
Oh, crap, Peter, it's a flash flood.
Oh, man, I better save my autographed picture of Dean Cain. You know, from before he got all desperate for attention.
Hey, is that Dean Cain on that park bench?
Oh, God.
Your plane set my lawn on fire!
Yeah, that ought to cover it.
Peter, I don't want your money!
Well, fine then. Have a box of Jeremy Irons cereal.
If you're looking for a prize at the bottom, there is none. Only more cardboard.
What was I thinking? Joe's the one with all the talent. Me trying to write a book is like CeeLo trying to find a pair of pants.
Yeah, I need to find something a cartoon apple would wear.
Calm down. Lots of crazy people have gone on to lead normal, successful lives.
I must look like a bigger loser than when I was on that game show.
And now back to America's favorite game show, Bobcat or Bjork.
Okay, Peter, listen closely and tell us if this is a song by Icelandic vocalist Bjork or the rantings of former comedian Bobcat Goldthwait. Here we go.
Oh, Bill, that's gotta be Bobcat.
Oh, sorry. That was Bjork.
Check it out, Stewie. Halle Berry's Wild Ride.
Cleve grew up and went on to marry Rebecca Romijn. Actually, I'm not even joking about that. The fat kid from Stand By Me is now married to Rebecca Romijn. Can you believe that? I swear to God, look it up on the internet. Doesn't that piss you off? Quag grew up to become a famous Hollywood actor. Unfortunately, about a week ago, he took an overdose of designer drugs at the Viper Room. He died on the curb outside. And now, we're left with a hair-lipped reminder of what might have been.
Hi, welcome back from commercials. Joaquin Phoenix, if you're still watching, you are a good sport and a trooper.
Well, look, we'd be happy to help in any way we can.
Hey, is Ron Howard's weird-looking brother one of these lab technicians?
Of course he is. It's an 80s movie.
Hey, there's something on the screen.
Lois? Where the devil is everyone? This place is more deserted than James Gandolfini's workout room.
You want to know how pathetic my life is? I've seen that Behind the Music with Leif Garrett 18 times.
Hey, Leif. It's been a while.
Too long, man. I'm so sorry about everything, man. I'm so...
Ready for a bombshell? You saved my life that night.
But I was driving. I
was on a road to destruction, man. The accident may have crippled me, but I'm alive, aren't I?
Can we turn off the cameras, dude?
I'm thinking of quitting.
What? Lois, you can't quit. What if Kurt Cobain had quit?
Thank you. And remember, say no to drugs.
Great concert, Kurt. The label's excited about your 7th album.
Thanks. Oh, you remember my wife, Courtney Love?
Who?
If you qualify as a genius, the foundation will give you a $500,000 grant just to sit around and do whatever you want.
Wow. Imagine what a genius like me could do with all that money. All right, Cloris Leachman, I've bought you legally. Now juggle these beanbags.
I don't know how to juggle.
God help you, Cloris, juggle the beanbags! Except when I was Christina Aguilera's manager. Okay, let me just go ahead and stop you right there. You sound terrible, all right? You're doing this thing, which is just, you know, what the hell is that? I mean, and you look like if I touched you, you'd be sticky, and frankly, you smell bad. You're pretty much offensive to all five senses.
That's only four.
Well, actually, you know when you smell something and it gets stuck in there and you can sort of taste it? Yeah, well, I'm tasting you right now, and it tastes awful. Truly disgusting, like salty garbage.
Yeah, I totally taste it.
I just hope it goes okay. We've had some bad luck with dinner guests. You remember when Margot Kidder was here?
Oh, we loved you in the Superman movies. You were just wonderful.
East of Eden? So you pretty much do whatever Oprah tells you to, huh?
You know, this book's been around for 50 years. It's a classic.
But you just got it last week, and there's a giant Oprah sticker on the front.
Oh, is that what that is? Let me just peel that right off.
So, what are you going to read after that one?
Well, she hasn't told us yet. Damn! That's the second most impressive trophy I've ever seen. And the Grammy for Album of the Year goes to Justin Timberlake. Ha! It actually goes to Nelly. Nelly.
Open up, Stewie. The airplane's coming in for a landing.
Yeah, I guess the pilot must have been JFK Jr. Ooh, even I found that to be in bad taste.
Man, this sucks worse than Easter Sunday at Richard Gere's house.
Okay, find the Easter egg.
I know where it is. It's in your butt.
No.
Yeah, I know the story. It's in your butt.
Mr. Griffin, if you just look on the ground for 5 seconds, I'm sure you'd find it.
Nope, in your butt.
Look, I'm tired of this stupid rumor.
In your butt.
Mr. Griffin.
Butt.
Mr.
Butt.
Griffin. You know what? Just get the hell out of here.
Fine, weirdo.
Without sex ed, kids can wind up sexually confused. Just look at Michael Jackson.
The kid in me likes the frosted side, but the grown-up in me likes the kid in me.
Ha! I knew it! I scared her off.
You might want to check under your pillow.
How did she get in? She must have been quieter than Britney Spears' dietitian.
Easy on those trans fats. Not everything needs gravy. You know, there's some carrots down at the other end. That cheesecake was for everyone.
All right, fine. You ruined this. This is more frustrating than Charlton Heston's funeral. Excuse me. Is this his cold, dead hand?
Yes.
He said I could take this.
Chris, are you all right? Please say something.
I don't think Jordan Peele has the talent we've attributed to him. Because of the lake water, I said some things that I did not mean. Jordan Peele is our greatest living filmmaker and visionary, both in comedy and in drama. There is nothing he can't do.
Good! Now let's make some twin porn!
Hit me again and you got a deal.
All right, Meg. You be David Koresh, and I'll be a heavy-handed FBI agent. Go! Hey, you! You're a crazy person! Come out of there, you!
Awesome! I'm gonna be a famous music star like Muddy Waters!
Muddy? Baby? Everything all right in there?
Oh, I think I'm about to pass a kidney stone!
God, that's Michael Eisner.
Oh, I'll take it from here, Julio. Here you go, Mr. Eisner. It's been Brianized. You might notice that new script smell. Every car I hand wash comes with a smile, an air freshener, and a copy of my can't-miss coming-of-age teen comedy set in Wisconsin.
What's your name?
Brian.
Let's see. There we go. Brian. See you at Disneyland.
Bring money.
Publicity is what keeps this franchise running, Brian. We're even using state-of-the-art computer animation to create a fake sex tape with me and Bill Cosby.
Now you will get ready for the zim-zam and the babbity-bibbity, and you will take off your clothes like voo and voom and get ready for the most splendiferous pudding pop you have ever seen.
Oh, this'll never get Meg on the paper. This is old news. There have been scandals in politics ever since Thomas Jefferson.
Hold on. Honey, let's get all the kids in this.
Taking credit for something a smart Jewish person did.
Oh, that's okay, Peter.
No. People have been doing that for too damn long.
It is the white devil that has propagated, exacerbated, instigated. Line?
It instigated our hatred like a Buick. God, wait, what was I thinking when I agreed to this? This is so degrading. This is worse than the time I was at the Friars Club and Sunyi's retainer fell out of my pants.
Yeah, it's hard, jagged, and tastes like alcohol. Just like kissing Faye Dunaway. Easy now.
Are we doing this thing or what? Brian? Well, this was a lot of effort for nothing. Like trying to tell Matthew McConaughey how much he sucks. You know, Matthew, I may not ever get another chance to say this, so I just want to get this off my chest. You are just awful. You're one of the worst actors in the history of film, and I think that you need to go away.
Oh, thanks, man. The truth is, I spend at least 90% of my year going away, exploring exotic places, having sex with my beautiful girlfriend, just doing sit-ups. I mean, that really... And then counting money. Money that I've made off the terrible films that I put out into the American populace because they just love to see me doing what it is that I do.
Yes, but you're not hearing me. Dazed and Confused was the one thing that was passable. After that...
Oh, thanks, man. That actually launched my career.
After that, everything else was awful. Contact, they didn't even need you in that movie. They could have done the whole movie without you.
I know. I said the same thing, but they were just like, oh, we need a good-looking guy with a great ass and some tight abs to just provide some down-home enthusiasm in this picture. Something to counterbalance Jodie Foster. They took her to be slightly cold. Unapproachable, you know, so they put me in there. I said it didn't make any sense. Said the same thing about that Bill Murray elephant movie, but they were just like, all the audiences need you.
You make me physically sick to my stomach, and I wish that you would get a heart attack.
I totally feel you, man. Truth of the matter is, I don't like my movies either, but, man, they just keep offering me money, and I do it, and then I get to go around the world. I mean, did you see Sahara? But I'll tell you what that movie gave me was an opportunity to take an Airstream all across the country and sell that picture one person at a time.
You suck donkey ass.
Now, you can't prove that.
And if I wore another color, I think it would just throw people.
You only have two white shirts?
Well, I had a third one, but it got ruined at that wine tasting at Michael J. Fox's house. Hi, I'm Peter Griffin. Now, we were going to show you the actual scene, but it would just make us all sad. So, I'm just going to tell you what happened. See, he has this disease, and it makes him shake a lot, and what with all the shaking, he spilled his wine all over my shirt, and my shirt was ruined. So that's what that was. I mean, he was very nice about it. He said, send me the bill. Actually, that's not how he said it, but, you know, we got there. Anyway, I sent him the bill, and he sent me this check, but I don't think I'm going to be able to cash this. You think Tracy Paulin would be in charge of the checkbook, you know? Because, I mean, what else is she doing right now? I mean, I don't think he's got the leverage to Rita Wilson her around town anymore. I mean, that's where it's gotten. So, anyway, that's what happened to my shirt. I'm glad we took the high road on this one. What's that? Oh, wait, now they're telling me they do want to show it. I really like the finish on this charade. Son of a bitch, what is your problem?
Oh, wow, this is awesome. You know Jeff Garlin has one of these in his house.
Ah, I love this chair. Dog in a Jets jersey, get in here. God, I have the best basement.
You sure about this, Peter?
You bet. As sure as I was when I created Lady Gaga. All right, listen, fella. Your game is confusion. Zip, zam, zoop. Nobody gets a straight look at nothing.
Whoa, is that Harrison Ford?
Yeah, it said in the brochure that he assists with all the jumps.
Get off my plane! Get off my plane! Get off my plane!
Oh, look, he even brought Callista Flockhart with him.
Peter, I think that's just a piece of paper.
Good, because she looked fat.
You should take my advice. I mean, I'm the guy who told Michael Chiklis to wear tight shirts.
I'll tell you anything you want. Just get your boobs out of my face.
You know the difference between you and me, dirtbag? No matter how muscular I get, I will never be muscular.
You can't quit. What if Muhammad Ali had quit?
Ah, my grandchildren. Who would like me to read them a book or maybe paint their name on a grain of rice?
Honey, dinner time.
Ah, my favorite, hot soup. Right in there.
I've got to get out of this house or I'll be in worse shape than John Goodman.
I've got your EKG here.
How does it look?
Well, it spells out pancakes.
Oh, okay, so same as last time.
I'm recommending you go on a strict diet immediately.
Nope. Horses that make it look like I can walk, take me to Hollywood.
She says I call Steinfeld Steinfeld? Of course I do. That's his name. Jerry Steinfeld. Pardon me, to quote his famous bit.
We now return to the Today Show with Matt Lauer sadly looking in the window.
First up, Rachel Ray will be here to help us with a simple Christmas recipe.
Can I come back now?
Then Al will be in to get you ready with your Christmas travel weather.
You guys still sore at me?
We also share your best tweets about family visitors.
I thought about what I did.
Then if you want a photo, you have to buy me candy.
I'm not buying you candy. Go to hell.
There's plenty of other CEOs who will. And Andrew Cuomo.
Who wants to see my nipple rings? Now bring that face over here for an unwanted smooch.
Hey, Mr. Weed, I got a great idea for a new line of TV action figures. Facts of Life Transformers, eh? And watch the transformation. Cute as a button. Fat as a cow. Radioactive scorpion, eh? Watch out, Mrs. Garrett. Here comes Blair.
We now return to CBS This Morning with Charlie Rose sadly pressed against the window.
Coming up this morning, Christmas came early for a group of first graders in South Bend, Indiana.
You guys still cross with me?
Now, hold on, Lois. Now, people do a lot of crazy things just to be accepted.
I don't know about this.
Hey, we all did it. If you want to be a Supreme Court justice, you got to pick up that cherry with your butt cheeks and drop it in that beer.
Come on. Come on, do it. Go shoot it. Go shoot it. Go shoot it.
I can't
is so in!
Hey, since I became president, profits have been higher than Alyssa Milano.
What kind of cheap shot, Joel?
I'm suing. I'm on it.
Peter, those questions are the easiest, most pandering things in the world.
Oh, Tim Hanks, Forrest Gump, I win.
Ho?
Well, I tried. I even hired M. Night Shyamalan to direct my TV commercial.
I have a secret to tell you.
What is it?
Come closer. I see good food at competitive prices.
At Big Pete's House of Munch. Step on by. Unfortunately, they couldn't air it, because it turns out M. Night Shyamalan was involved with September 11th.
Ladies and gentlemen, Elvis Presley.
Huh? What? Elvis Presley is white? Cleveland, did you know about this?
Come on, Donna. Let's pick up some gizzards and fried skins and head on down to the juke joint. Tonight, it's gonna be jumping.
I had him pump my stomach, too. Doc, what was in there?
Well, it's a pretty extensive list. I'm gonna need Billy Joel to help me out.
Lots of Legos, rubber bands, web shooting, Spider-Man, an old pet rock, an antique clock, a ton of red Play-Doh. Colored pencils, lots of nickels, half a jar of plastic pickles, banjo strings, chicken wings, a single by Skilo.
I didn't poop those items. They were in my tummy, cause they all look yummy.
He didn't poop those items. He tried to eat them, so you shouldn't feed him.
Wow, that was great, Billy. Hey, does anyone call you Bill Joel or William Joel?
No. Does anyone call you Petey Griffin?
No, they don't, because I'm an adult, which is kind of what I was getting at.
All right, deal.
Awesome. I feel like I've finally found my calling, like Steve Martin.
I've got it. I'll do 5 years of entertainment, then 40 years of banjo. Hello. No, I don't want $10 million for a movie. Call back when you've got 14 banjo fans in your city's worst theater.
Honey, could you shut the door? Honey, shut the door!
Your mother's right, son. Listen to what it says.
Peter.
I didn't say that. Lee Majors did.
What? Women are things.
Do like me, say wee-wee, and tell him you're a friend of Bill Maher's.
That's how you'll get to watch them pee in Canadian nudie bars.
Damn, I drove all the way out here. I had to cancel another appointment. I never like to be too far away from Mike Wallace.
Oh, boy, this is going to be fun. I haven't made a crank call in years. Quiet, it's ringing.
Hello?
Hello? Is this Linda Tripp?
Yes.
You shouldn't have talked, you stupid bitch! I hope you die! Boy, that wasn't really a crank call. That was just unpleasant.
Sorry about that.
It's okay.
Oh, don't be so hard on yourself. It's okay to be easily distracted. That's what saved Warren Beatty and Annette Bening's marriage.
Annette, let's have sex.
Or you could watch Blue Bloods and have a pudding cup.
Go get 'em, Blue Bloods.
That must be where they do the deed. I hope it's at least peaceful and humane.
Vic!
Oh, boy.
And Eli Manning!
Oh, I didn't know that about Eli Manning.
Oh, yeah. I'm a real idiot psychopath.
Funny how this worked out. Who would have thought, huh?
I guess things not always what they seem.
Yeah. I mean, except for Ronan Farrow, who is clearly Woody Allen's son and absolutely not Frank Sinatra's.
I'm glad you could make it home for the family dinner, Ronan.
You got it, Four Eyes. Wouldn't miss a dinner with my cuckoo dad for the world. Hey, Anime Wong, no ticky, no shirty. I'm just kidding around, Rice Bowl. Jeez, lighten up. This room is tighter than Ava Gardner's caboose. Us, right? It's like looking in a mirror.
Is that car bed a Bentley? And is that guy the driver?
Ready for this evening's trip to Snooze Town, sir?
Not yet. Sad story. He used to drive the bed for Michael Jackson's monkey.
I've seen some terrible things.
Look at them. They're getting along like Billy Bob Thornton and his cat.
Billy Bob?
Leave me alone. I'm taking a bath.
I want to see if there's a response to all those fan letters I've been writing.
Dear Carrie Elways, I have been meaning to contact you for some time. I have never been able to figure out if you are famous. You were a big deal in one thing, but you were wearing a mask for most of it. Do you consider your career a disappointment? Or rather, did you exceed your own expectations? Yours truly, Peter Griffin. P.S. You were in Robin Hood, Men in Tights. Did you know that?
Oh, I feel as pretty as Scarlett Johansson.
Scarlett Johansson!
Scarlett Johansson!
Scarlett Johansson!
Scarlett!
Scarlett!
Laura Linney. Whoops.
I dated Ross 20 years ago.
That's right, and that means he had you first, Lois. I'll always be Scottie Pippen to his Michael Jordan.
Ladies and gentlemen, Michael Jordan!
And Scottie Pippen.
He's also good.
Why didn't they do Jordan last?
Alphabetical?
Oh, right. That's smart. You're smart, but still.
We now return to How David Lynch Stole Christmas.
Hello. I got you a present. It's a thumb.
Huh?
Don't look away. Let the fear wash over you.
I don't understand.
That's the whole point. Now, did you leave a plate of black coffee out for me?
No.
In the future, please leave a plate of black coffee out for me. Also in the past.
Oh, God, I've ruined Christmas. Like the little drummer boy when he got really into Neil Peart.
Our finest gifts we bring, pa-ra-pa-pom-pom.
Late night TV is all terrible.
Oh, we don't have to watch this. We could turn to channel 875 and watch Conan.
Here, let me see what else is on.
In honor of Sammy, on the bus ride over here, we all sat in the back. Lucille Ball was back there with us, and I saw her smoking a Cuban. And then Desi zipped up his fly. Whose wedding is this? It's hilarious.
Peter, it's not a wedding. It's an infomercial for the Dean Martin celebrity roasts.
Well, I have to admit, you two do make a cute couple. But then again, so did Chris Martin and Gwyneth Paltrow.
Do you take this woman to lecture you about trans fats for as long as you both shall live?
I do.
And do you take this man to be a watered-down Bono until death do you part?
I do.
I now pronounce you pretentious and terrible. You may name your daughter after a fruit.
Ah! Cat butt! What do I do? Where do I look? What do I do? Oh, thank God. I almost looked right at it. Ah! I looked right at it! Oh, it looks like a worn-out dartboard bullseye. How was Michael Jackson so into this?
I made it to Wimbledon and got to play in front of the Queen, Freddie Mercury. I altered my 40-bounce routine just for him. It was an honor playing for Freddie on grass that day. He later died. The doctor said it was asphalt.
Ladies and gentlemen, to support Pawtucket Pat, please welcome Kid Rock.
Hello, Quahog! Whenever there's a town debate with racial overtones, I'm there on the wrong side!
Whoa! Oh, crap, everybody run! It's adult Rock!
Kid, you want to tell me why I found your mother's best t-shirt cutting scissors outside in the rain?
I don't know.
Why can't you be more like your brother, the...
Guess I'm stuck in the middle with you. And I'm wondering what it is I should do. It's so hard to keep the smile from my face.
Let's face it, this is the most fun we've had since Mom got hooked on coffee and bought that Al Pacino maker.
Good job, Chris. You've really impressed your old dad. Like Richard Gere's gerbil impressed his dad.
Hello?
Dad, you're never gonna believe where I am.
Man, this is a pretty sweet gig. Like being a member of Daft Punk.
Look at this old Casio keyboard from the 1980s that I have found. Watch what happens when I push this demo button.
Hello, Daft Punk. Great song. Here's a Grammy.
Oh, ho!
You know, it's funny. Until you spoke, I did not know we were French.
You're gonna fail faster than John Madden's wedding video business.
Boom! Here's your groom over here. Boom! You got your bride right here. And a lot of people say that Stacy's no good and that she slept with this guy and done that guy and even this guy. But I'll tell you something. That experience is gonna work in her favor late in the game. You know what a heck of a wedding? Brett Favre.
I don't know, but I ordered him a beer and now he's just sitting there looking lonelier than Alan Rickman's answering machine.
Hello. You've reached Alan Rickman at 555-0122. Please leave a message at the beep. Hello, Alan Rickman. It's Alan Rickman. Reminding you to move the pork chops from the freezer to the refrigerator so they defrost properly. Do not disappoint me. Hello. You've reached Alan Rickman at 555-0122. Please leave a message at the beep. Alan, it's me again. Remember that turtle joke for the party?
Boy, I can't believe there'd be corrupt cops in Mexico.
Yeah, Donald Trump was right. His daughter is a hot piece of ass.
Some fresh in your life, let Mentos freshen up your life. Life is just a breeze when you stay fresh and cool, cause Mentos puts the fresh in life.
Chase that freshness, just can't beat it. Mentos freshness, Mentos fresh in your life.
Mentos, the fresh maker.
Come on, we'll do it ourselves. Stewie Griffin, I baptize you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost.
And Space Ghost.
What are you doing? Oh my God, this is almost as bad as my bath with Kathy Bates.
Yeah, I think I'm gonna get out.
I thought I was actually connecting with people. Could there be anyone stupider than me?
Madonna?
Oh, yeah, she's pretty stupid. That's something we can all agree on, right? Right?
Absolutely, yeah. Francis?
Oh, major idiot. Major idiot.
Yeah, yeah. Well, gosh, you know, I guess we do have some common ground here after all, huh?
Yeah, and La Isla Bonita, not a real place. I looked it up, couldn't find it. Bought a globe, couldn't find it.
Well, yeah, that makes her a liar, too.
She's awful.
Awful, awful woman.
I agree, yeah.
And she's a whore.
Oh, yeah, big time.
Oh, everybody. Yeah, Canseco? Ew.
Dennis Rodman?
Dennis Rodman, right, right, yeah.
Rodman? My God.
I think he lost all his money, didn't he?
Rodman lost? You're not thinking of MC Hammer?
No, no. Him too. I read somewhere. I think it was in like Stuff. Or no. You know what it was? It was on Real Sports with Bryant Gumbel, and they said that he's in the poorhouse now. Yeah.
You think she'd do him now?
Would Madonna do Rodman now? Oh, yeah. No, because it's not about the money. It's about pissing off Daddy.
That's right. She's got a lot of problems. A
lot of problems.
Yeah, we are smarter. We are smarter than Madonna.
Oh, no question.
Well, I should probably get out of these robes.
Brian, you still watching TV? God, you've been sitting there since I left.
I spent all morning watching a VH1 special on Gwen Stefani. I don't know what a hollaback girl is. All I know is I want her dead.
I promise you'll love it here, even more than Julia Roberts loves herself.
Hi, I'm Julia Roberts. You know, a lot of people died in the tsunami, but don't worry. I didn't. And I'll be here to entertain you and love my life for many, many years to come. Me. Me. Me.
Well, I guess he couldn't be any worse than Tim McCarver is at sportscasting.
In my view, as good as the Yankees were in the first half of this game, that's how as bad they've been now.
Joe, you got this all wrong. Like God did when he made Rosie O'Donnell.
You can't put a vagina on this man.
Why not? I'm God.
Well, what do you want to do about the breasts?
Take a couple out of the bin we can't find matches for.
Finally!
Up next, Kirk Cameron.
Ooh.
To talk about God.
Ow.
I'm not special?
Everyone's special, Peter.
Rock drummer Tommy Lee?
And if your wife ever tells you that you're not special, punch her really hard right in her hepatitis.
Thanks, rock drummer Tommy Lee.
Hey, you know what else is cool? Having sex with sunglasses on.
I've got a lot of things to try now.
Quagmire? I thought you were still out on the road.
I was, but then I thought, what was Simon without Garfunkel?
Wildly successful?
We will never stop fighting for this booth. This booth is my home. I was born in this booth. I was married in this booth. My children were all conceived in this booth. Hell, I witnessed every significant historical event in my lifetime right here. I was in this booth when the Challenger exploded. Oh, my God, no. I was in this booth on 9/11. Oh, my God, no. I was in this booth when President Obama was elected. Oh, my God, no.
Okay, I'll give you a tiny bit of this. It should help you sleep.
What is it?
It's cough syrup. It's not really for kids, but a capful is pretty harmless.
Hmm. Oh, so this is what Lil Wayne keeps almost dying from.
I don't understand. I'm not a racist. It's well documented that my dream three-way is S, Apatha Murkison, and CCH Pounder. S, this is CCH. CCH, this is S. It is my intention that we conduct this with both sexiness and dignity.
Let's go knock on the door of the next room and ask them which one of us is fat.
Oh, I'm so sorry I'm not Bradley Hooper.
It's Koopa, not Hooper. You're thinking of Mr. Hooper from Sesame Street, and I'd sooner bang him. He was a business owner. He was a successful man.
Look at all this traffic.
Yeah, Brady Boulevard is tight this time of day. You know what? Cut over to Brady on Brady, and then take the Brady Bridge.
Is everything in this town named after Tom Brady?
Oh, no. There's the Rob Gronkowski Library. The only book is just a label ripped off a Muscle Milk bottle.
And look, there's the Robert Kraft Marina, full of tugboats.
I heard he had a stroke. Man, I can't get over how old-timey everything in this car is.
I know. Check out what's on the radio.
President Kennedy has been shot.
The Martians are now traveling to New Jersey.
Beatles song, la 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 la.
Ah, that last one brings back a lot of memories.
Even Helen Keller had her tailor.
$100, please, blind and deaf lady!
Well, we can, but I'm not sure you'll like it.
That's what I look like? Who is letting me out of the house like someone in the future is seriously failing me?
Yeah, you look like a Candyland villain that came to life.
I know!
You look like a Muppet that teaches kids about being gay.
All right, that's enough. Why are we making fun of me? I'm not a bad guy. Let's just make fun of Sean Hannity again.
He looks like a guy who just OD'd on Just for Men.
He looks like Alan Thicker.
He's a guy whose wife yells at him for getting his ball powder all over the bathroom.
All right, we could do this all day. For more Hannity slams, go to Family Guy's YouTube page. And hey, if you think of your own, leave it in the comments.
He's the guy your mom dates twice and then yells at you for the remote.
Okay, but now we're done.
Peter, quick, write something mean. You're doing to this game what R. Kelly did to all those... Yeah, no, I'm not saying the rest of that.
Now, if you ladies don't mind stepping out, I have to reprimand Danny McBride next. Mr. McBride, do you know why you're here?
Yeah, maybe because I'm awesome, and you're a gay homosexual, and also the word jet ski a lot?
Yeah, you know why you're here.
Meg, I'm not doing this.
You have to, Chris. Siblings have to look out for each other, like the Mannings.
Eli, you threw for 3 touchdowns today, which isn't bad, except Peyton had 4.
Well, Cooper got pre-approved for a Visa card today. Come on, guys. We all had a good day.